Okay, so let's move over here to these edit pages. And this is where a lot of the rhythmic magic happens in Mass. There are four of these, quantization, delay, gator, and EQ. Quantization, of course, is the process of confining hits to certain rhythmic subdivisions. So, for example, I mean, the most obvious application is if someone's late on a drum hit, quantization will move that drum hit closer to being perfectly on time, or exactly on time, if that's what you want. And it's also used for applying swing. So in this quantization page, what we have are a number of different parameters, but this top one, this field here, is a series of presets that you can scroll through by clicking on it and dragging up or down. I guess dragging down in this case. The one that it loads with is this kind of standard offbeat shuffle. So we'll leave it there. Now, the knob to the right here is a master shuffle effect, if I have that right, which dictates the total amount of shuffle that can be applied to the individual tracks. Below is a grid size alteration tool. I don't really touch this. It doesn't affect the sound. It changes the size of these sequencer tracks that you're seeing and the subdivisions. But over here is where you really get your money's worth, because these six bars that are illuminated here are really faders. And what these do is apply to each one of the respective six sequencer tracks the amount of shuffle that you want for that track. So let's take an example of these hats. And let's go, say for example, instead of this one hat per bar, we'll just draw a hat in on every beat of the bar. Now this one you see here is a dark gray. That indicates that there's a triplet mode enabled. So if we listen to this, and it kind of hiccups there, that's a different triplet mode. But it's a very straightened beat. Well, it's pretty straight, right? But now if we start to add this shuffle, and we know this is the fourth track down, so we'll go up here. This is a little finicky because you gotta actually be right on the bar. But if you go to this four and you start cranking that up, here's what you're gonna hear, right? A lot more swing. So if we get our kick drum in the mix, and you hear that's completely changed the character of the rhythm, right? We've gone from essentially this. Oh, that was nice in there. So that's how you apply shuffle. And the brilliant thing about this is that you apply it to individual tracks. Right, just because you have shuffle applied to the hats doesn't necessarily mean you want the same shuffle applied to the snare drum or to a side stick or whatever else you have in the mix. So keep that in mind.